The administration did not negotiate a good treaty. They went into the negotiations, it seems to me, with the attitude with the Russians, just like the guy that goes into the car dealership and says, I'm not leaving here until I buy a car. And I think that's the approach that was taken, and the result is pretty clear. Over time, and if we had the right process here for people to have an open mind, to have a good debate and think about the changes that we're proposing, I think over time it would be possible to make some changes, either to the treaty, the preamble, or the resolution of ratification, to deal with some of the more serious problems that we've identified. But obviously we don't have that time here. And when folks that are proponents of the treaty say, well, we've been on it now for 6 days or 7 days, you all know what that process is like. Parachute in this issue, have a vote on that, go back to the treaty, come back, have two votes on judges, go back to the treaty, now it's dinner time, well, we'll come back tomorrow, now we have to do a cloture vote on this or that. All of these interruptions and the season have resulted in a situation in which very few members are paying much attention, very few are on the floor really thinking about this, and frankly, the other side does not have an open mind about accepting anything. If this were done next year, by the way, we're talking next month when we talk about next year, January. We're talking 5 weeks from now, not exactly a huge amount of time. I think there would be the time to do this with an open mind on the part of the other side. I don't think any of the members of the Democratic Party have voted for a single amendment here. I might be wrong, but I don't think any of them have. That shows a very partisan approach to this treaty. And I think it's just basically, let's hurry up and get this over with, is the attitude.